Now think about these 18 years all the time. I can't get it back.
Dennis Williams spent 18 years on Illinois' death row.
I try not to think about this, but I had at least 3 execution dates set.
Dates that were set after Williams and 3 other men were convicted in the rape and murder of a young couple. The men, who came to be known as the Ford Heights Four, always maintained their innocence.
I wouldn't ever do anything as horrible as murder, as rape, as aggravated kidnap, as armed violence. You know, I'd never do anything like that.
In 1996, science concluded what a jury did not. Their blood and semen did not match evidence found at the crime scene. Williams and his co-defendants were set free. Based on cases like this one, in 1997, Illinois passed the nation's most comprehensive law giving prison inmates the right to DNA testing.
It brings us closer to what the system is supposed to do, and that is determine the truth.
What makes the law even more striking is that it was sponsored by State Senator Ed Petka, a former prosecutor who put 7 people on death row.
This is not going to be a gusher that just pushes people out of prison, because the bill has been carefully designed to ensure that the individuals who are using this procedure are in a position where it can truly help them.
Because increasing numbers of convicted criminals, including death row inmates, have been set free by DNA, many old cases have been getting a new look. Walter Rowe contributed to a Justice Department report entitled Convicted by Juries, Exonerated by Science.
We've since come to realize that DNA is incredibly stable and can persist not just for decades, but still be detectable hundreds, thousands, and even millions of years later.
For Dennis Williams, who had to fight 18 years for the kind of testing that Illinois now allows, the issue is a simple one. Without DNA testing,
I wouldn't be sitting here talking to you right now. I'd be in the cemetery decaying now.
He says God and science saved his life.
When I wake up now every morning, the first thing I do silently, you know, is thank God that I'm free.